two iconic slasher supervillains. One fight to the death. Jason Voorhees and Michael Myers are two of the most recognizable fictional murderers in the history of cinema. Both are masked, brutal killers. But who would win in a fight? That's the question we're asking right now on Life's Biggest Questions. Hello and welcome back to a special Halloween edition of Life's Biggest Questions. On this channel, we explore a variety of topics, from history to horror films, from politics to science. I'm Charlotte Jobry, and if this is your first time here, hit that subscribe button and ask us a question in the comments. And if you need a place to get your news on YouTube, check out our sister channel, Inform Overload, for updates on daily news that you actually want to hear about, also hosted by me. Friday the 13th was actually inspired by Halloween. Friday the 13th was released 2 years after Halloween. So if it weren't for Michael, slasher movies wouldn't even exist, and neither would Jason Voorhees. In their later films, both Michael Myers and Jason Voorhees appear to become immortal. So let's just assume that this fight takes place before that happens for both of them. It just gets a little bit messy otherwise. So before we can decide who would win in a fight, I'm gonna share what we know about each of these ruthless killers. Starting things off with Michael Myers. Michael Myers was introduced during the release of Halloween in 1978. Myers is a psychopath who wears a Captain Kirk mask that's painted white. Has no sense of empathy for other humans, and that began in childhood, maybe even at birth. He killed his own sister when he was only 6 years old, and was sent to an insane asylum to serve out a life sentence. Dr. Loomis believed that Myers is essentially the embodiment of all evil, because there's no rhyme or reason for his murderous nature. Myers confessed to his grandmother that voices tell him to hate people. He breaks out of the hospital on Halloween evening many years later, and begins his killing spree. Myers learned to fight by watching Bonanza during the time he spent in the psychiatric hospital. He is stealthy, strong, and durable. Michael's weapon of choice is a kitchen knife. He's killed 107 people. His height is 6'1", and he weighs 205 pounds. His only weakness? Cats, apparently. Michael hates dogs, and has killed more than a few. In the first Halloween, he kills a German Shepherd. In Halloween 4, he kills a Golden Retriever. In Halloween 5, he kills a Doberman. But in Part 5, he spares a box of kittens. We can then assume that maybe he's got a soft spot for cats. Jason Voorhees was first introduced in the film Friday the 13th in 1980. Jason grew up normal. He had a loving mother and a pretty decent childhood. But when he was a kid, he went swimming with a friend in Crystal Lake at summer camp, and word spread that he ended up drowning. His counselors at camp did not try and save him because I guess they were too busy having an orgy. Jason's mother, Pam, responds to the death of her son by slaughtering all the camp counselors. Meanwhile, Jason hadn't actually died. He killed his only friend and witnessed his mother killing all his counselors. So it's safe to say that this killer was born out of a traumatic event. He spends out the rest of his days in the woods, slowly going more and more insane, while he kills anyone who so happens to wander into the woods at Camp Crystal Lake. Now some stats. Jason wears a hockey mask, and wildly wields around a machete, but he's also pretty strong in general, and can break your face with just his two hands. Voorhees can also stay underwater for long periods of time. He's a brutal killer. So far, he's killed around 145 people that we know of. Jason is also a lot bigger and stronger than Michael. He weighs 270 pounds, and he's 6'8". That being said, Voorhees has been known to be clumsy and unintelligent, definitely not advantageous when he's up against some serious competition like Michael Myers. There are a few differences between Michael Myers and Jason Voorhees, but the main one is, Michael was born a psychopath. Jason went crazy due to a traumatic event. Because Michael is a psychopath, he has little to no emotion. This isn't the case for Jason Voorhees. Jason still has emotions, and he can still feel emotions like fear, which means that Jason is still more human than Michael. Because he's more human, he's weaker. Unlike Jason, Michael Myers kills for the fun of it. Jason kills out of fear and self-defense. Michael is also more skilled when it comes to fighting. Jason grew up in the woods, and even though he's killed a lot more people than Michael Myers, and he's a lot bigger in general, he basically just swings around his machete wildly. If he were up against someone who did know how to fight, he might not stand a chance. Being bigger doesn't always mean that you'd beat someone else in a fight. So a fight between Michael and Jason would probably go something like this. Michael Myers would enter the Camp Crystal Lake woods chasing after a victim. He comes across Jason Voorhees, another masked killer. Michael examines his adversary, approaching him slowly and stealthily. Jason then lunges at Michael, repeatedly, while swinging around his machete. But Michael is much more skilled at fighting than Jason. Jason's erratic behavior is scary for sure, but definitely not effective in a setting like the woods. Michael would probably dodge Jason's advances and wait for Jason to make a foolish mistake, like tripping on a tree branch, before he quickly and expertly removed his head with a kitchen knife. I mean, I've got a pretty active imagination, but you get the picture. There is a pretty clear winner to me, and that's Michael Myers. Unless Jason Voorhees used a box of kittens as a shield, I don't see him being a match for Michael Myers. Let's be honest, Halloween is still the greatest slasher movie ever made, so maybe I'm a bit biased, but did you agree with me? Did you not? Why don't you let me know in those comments? For now, I'm Charlotte Jobry, and you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you enjoyed this video, you will love the video that's clickable on the screen right now. And don't forget to show this channel some love by leaving a thumbs up, subscribing, and turning on notifications so we can see you in a future episode of Life's Biggest Questions.